Can I ask you about another policy and sort of fixation of economists right now, modern monetary theory?
Yeah.
Can you just, in shorthand, describe it for our viewers?
No. Okay. I cannot describe it for your viewers because...
Because it makes no sense.
No, when you try to talk to the MMT people, and you say, so this is what you're saying, they say, no, you just don't get it.
But as I understand it as a layman, it rests on, at least one of the ideas it rests on, is that the U.S. government can actually not go bankrupt because it is in charge of the money supply.
Yeah, that's a... this is basically true. But you don't need a new theory for that. We kind of knew that already. To a large extent, they're just doing Keynesian economics, but not... They don't know that they're doing Keynesian economics, and they've invented their own terminology for it.
So can you help me understand, in 2011, when you first wrote about modern monetary theory, you said, in a way, I should really not spend time debating it because these guys are on my side of the current political debates and policy debates. It's unlikely that they'll ever have any real kind of influence.
Yeah.
So you sort of dismiss them as sort of being, you know, cranks on the far left.
Yeah. Well, no, I'm not even sure it's on the far left. I mean, it's not at all clear that an MMT perspective, whatever that is, because they're very hard to decipher, leads to any more
the major
leftist
economist of the MMT, the person whose name is most on it, Stephanie Kelton, was an advisor to Bernie Sanders' campaign 4 years ago. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, many of the new progressives on the left have associated themselves with her, her ideas, her publications, and this theory. So I think it is fair to say that it is a theory that it resides and is, frankly, gaining popularity on the progressive left.
Yeah, but if the content is not actually especially leftist, not more so than a conventional Keynesian view. I mean, if anything, I could get too technical here, but if anything, I would say that a conventional Keynesian view gives you more room for deficit spending than MMT does, because MMT doesn't really give you any role for monetary policy to control inflation. But the main point is, it's substantively, it's hard to see that it makes any difference.